Today I'm going to teach you how to play two beginner linear drum fills. So let's get started. Hey everyone, my name is Gabe and I'm from drumbeatsonline.com. Today I'm going to teach you some awesome linear drum fills that I'm super excited about. Before we jump into that, I just want to explain to you real quick what the term linear means. And that just means that no two drums are hitting at the same time. So if I'm hitting my snare drum, that's the only drum I'm hitting. I'm not hitting the floor tom at the same time or anything like that. So it's a pretty simple concept, but it can really help you be a lot more creative in your beats and, in this case, our fills. So let's start with our first linear drum fill. The first thing we're gonna do in this drum fill is we're gonna hit our ride cymbal. So real simple, just hit it like this. So you're just gonna hit it once like that, and immediately after that, you're gonna hit your rack tom four times. So together, that would sound like this. So that's the first part of the fill. The second part is almost the exact same thing. We're going to start off by hitting our ride cymbal once, but then this time we're going to our floor tom, and we're playing that four times as well. So that sounds like this. So combining those two parts together, it sounds like this. So the third part of this fill is similar, but a little bit different. We're gonna start off by hitting the ride cymbal, and then we're gonna hit our snare drum two times. So instead of four, like on the toms, we're just hitting this one twice. So that would sound like this. So I'll play it for you all together real quick, but a quick overview is we've got our ride cymbal, and then four times on the rack tom, then ride cymbal, four times on the floor tom, ride cymbal, twice on the snare drum. So I'll loop that a few times and try to play along if you want to. So that feels a ton of fun to play. If you wanted to give it a little bit more power, instead of hitting the ride every time, you could hit one of your crashes, and that would kind of give it a bigger sound. But feel free to experiment with that one. It's a ton of fun. So this second fill is a little bit harder than the first one, but it sounds really, really cool. So what we're going to do is we're going to start off by playing four notes on our snare drum. So that would sound like this. So that's pretty simple, but it starts to get tricky right after that. So after you play your four notes on the snare drum, you're going to hit two notes on the bass drum. So for some of you beginners, that can be kind of tricky. Playing two notes on the bass drum isn't necessarily always an easy thing, especially as you start getting faster. So my recommendation would just be to take this fill slow, and then you'll be able to build up the speed in your foot, and then you'll be able to play it faster. So we've got four notes on the snare drum and then two notes on the bass drum. That sounds like this. So an important thing to note in this drum fill is that it maintains the same sticking pattern throughout the whole fill. And that is right, left, kick, kick. and we're just going to be moving that around this drum fill. So the next part of this drum fill is we're going to hit two on the rack tom and then two on the snare drum. So right, left, and then again, kick, kick. That sounds like this. So combining part one with part two would sound like this. So part three is the easiest part, and that's just four notes on your floor tom, like this. Pretty simple. So if you can make it to that point, you're in good shape. So now let's try to play it all together nice and slow. I'm going to loop it a few times and try to play along. So that fill is a ton of fun to play, especially when you can kind of get it up to speed. But if you're not at that point yet, don't be discouraged. It's a very tricky fill. So take your time with it. Play it as slow as you can. Get the form right. Just like in weightlifting, you don't want to walk into the gym, put all the weight on the bench press, and just try to lift it for the first time. You have to start off light and take it real slow and get the form down before you can start getting to that place. So take it slow. And from there, you'll be able to move quickly to playing it fast. So let's move on to our tip of the day. For this fill specifically, I want to challenge you to try to experiment with the last part of the fill. So when we're normally just playing the four notes on the floor tom, I want you to try to move that around the drum kit. You can keep the part one and part two the same, but part three, try to change up a little bit. It'll help you be more creative with some of your other fills, and just learning how to experiment and change things around is really, really important for drummers. So I'm going to give you a few examples, and hopefully it gives you some ideas of how to change this fill up a little bit. So there's just a few ideas. It's just four notes, and just try to put them in different places. It can sound really, really cool. So my question for you guys is, what is your biggest struggle with linear drumming? Do you have a hard time coming up with new linear fills or linear beats? Let me know in the comment section below. And if you're looking for some full-length beginner drum lessons, please check out my whole lesson course package called Ultimate Beginner Drum Lessons. I put hours and hours of work into this, and it's my best drum lessons by far. If you want, you can check it out right here. And if not, check out my last YouTube lesson right here. Thanks so much for watching this lesson, guys. It means so much to me, and I really, really appreciate your support. Hopefully, I'll see you next time. See you guys.